In this scene, we shall discuss some of the basic principles of animal endocrinology. Endocrinology is the study of hormones, their chemistry, synthesis, and physiological actions. What is a hormone? A hormone is a cell-to-cell signaling chemical found in multicellular organisms that is synthesized and released by a secretory tissue and transported in the circulatory system to distant target cells where it exerts a profound physiological response. There are four types of signaling chemicals that fall into the following categories. Autocrine signaling is by chemicals that affect their source cell or directly adjacent cells. Paracrine signaling is the diffusion of a signaling chemical from one cell to nearby non-adjacent cells. Endocrine signaling is by chemicals called hormones, synthesized by specific glandular cells that is released into the circulatory system to affect distant target cells. Finally, neurosecretory signaling is a fourth category of cell signaling. Neurons typically secrete signaling chemicals at synaptic junctions and muscle motor end plates as part of their normal functions in the nervous system. Therefore, it is reasonable that nervous structures include specific neurosecretory neurons that secrete hormones, which are usually proteins or peptides. How do hormones exert their effects on target tissues? Target cells contain receptor proteins that bind the hormone and stimulate a target cell response. There are basically two mechanisms of action depending on the hormone's chemical properties. Oil-soluble hormones, such as steroid hormones, dissolve in the lipids that comprise cell membranes and enter into target cells where they bind with receptor proteins in the cytoplasm and nucleus. The receptor proteins carry the hormones into the nucleus where they interact with genes to activate gene expression. In summary, the hormone-activated genes transcribe their DNA code into RNA. The RNA then passes from the nucleus to the cytoplasm where the RNA transcript of the DNA code is translated into the specific proteins required to produce the hormone-regulated physiological response. In contrast, if the hormone is water-soluble, such as protein and peptide hormones, they act on the cell surface through a G-protein receptor. G-protein receptors are proteins consisting of 7 hydrophobic transmembrane spanning regions. The receptor is associated with a G protein that is comprised of alpha, beta, and gamma subunits. The peptide hormone assumes its active configuration, fits onto the receptor binding site, and conveys its message. The message results in a conformational change in the receptor that is transferred mechanically to the G protein. Mechanical activation of the G protein results in the alpha subunit replacing guanosine diphosphate with guanosine triphosphate. The activated alpha subunit separates from the beta and gamma subunits and migrates within the plasma membrane to an inactive phospholipase C enzyme. Energy captured from the hydrolysis of the terminal phosphate of guanosine triphosphate is transferred through the alpha subunit to activate the phospholipase C. The process of activating the phospholipase C converts the guanosine triphosphate back to guanosine diphosphate, and the alpha subunit rejoins the beta and gamma subunits to reform the inactive G protein. Activated phospholipase C degrades phospholipids that make up the plasma membrane to produce two second messengers, inositol-1,4,5-trisphosphate and diacylglycerol. The inositol-trisphosphate is released from the membrane and binds to a receptor on the endoplasmic reticulum. This intracellular signal results in the release of calcium stored within the endoplasmic reticulum. The released calcium, plus the diacylglycerol from the membrane, activate an inactive protein kinase enzyme in the plasma membrane. The activated protein kinase facilitates the transfer of a high-energy phosphate group from adenosine triphosphate to an inactive enzyme. Protein kinase phosphorylation activates the enzyme to initiate the physiological events regulated by the water-soluble peptide hormone. Other water-soluble hormones use a G-protein activation of adenylyl cyclase to convert ATP to cyclic adenosine monophosphate. The cyclic AMP then acts as a second messenger to activate a similar cascade of hormone-related physiological events. By producing multiple intracellular second messengers, the extracellular primary message by the hormone is magnified within the target cell so that a single hormone molecule can produce a larger cellular response. Within an organism, there is an abundance of ligand-specific G proteins, and they are a favorite target for pharmaceutical design. Now that we have discussed the basic concepts of endocrinology, let us turn to insect hormones, their tissue sources, and the endocrine-regulated physiological processes of insects.